the more I listen to you, the more my dis-ease-ness arises. Although in the session, I am very silent, but the noise keeps on multiplying with every passing day. The only way I find is to engage myself in some work or sleep. These are also getting difficult. The truth is the giver of supreme peace. And the truth is also that which keeps us peaceless. It does not depend on the truth. It depends on us. Closeness to truth, unity with truth is peace. And distance from truth is dis-ease, peacelessness. When you feel restless or peaceless, you should take it as an invitation of peace or truth. Surely there is something in our ways, your ways, that is not aligned with the truth, that is keeping you distant from the truth. And that is why the restlessness, the suffering is arising. In that sense, suffering is like an alarm bell. Even more like an invitation call. You can say suffering is experienced when the call of the truth dislodges you from your present position. So suffering should not be taken as something unwanted, undesirable, or a punishment. Suffering means that peace is calling. And peace is calling implies two things. One, good news, peace is calling. Bad news, peace is calling only because you are away from peace. But both these taken together, it is still very good news. You might be distant from peace, but peace is still calling. Still calling. And this call and your resistance to heed to the call expresses itself as suffering. You feel torn apart. You feel a conflict. This is what you are representing here as dis-ease, unease. On one hand are your set patterns. On the other hand, something bigger, higher is calling. On one hand, there is the attraction, the fixation that you have with your current and planned way of life. On the other hand, there is the pull of the unpredictable, of the fresh, of the new. The charm of total liveliness. On one hand is security. On the other hand is sensitivity. You feel torn apart, as if somebody has driven a wedge in your psyche. Hmm? Very often we attribute such suffering to the truth. You are right in attributing this to the truth. But the truth is present in this entire scene as the provider of solace, not as the cause of suffering. If the truth is calling you, it is not to further your suffering, it is to provide you with relief. It is just that the call reveals that you are diseased. So what do we start thinking? That the truth is the cause of the disease. The truth is not the cause of the disease. The truth is just exposing the disease and inviting you to be disease free. But the ego wants to lay blame upon somebody else. So it says, you know, I was doing well in my settled life. I was doing well as I was. But this situation, this book or this fellow opened up something else to me and now I am suffering. Why is he showing the alternate world to me? Why is he showing the other dimension to me? He is to be blamed for my suffering. He is not to be blamed for your suffering. In fact, he is opening the doors of redemption for you. Are you getting it? One is hurt and hurt badly. So badly that one gets numb at that place. Now one may not feel the suffering, but something is dying within him. A doctor comes and as a first step of the treatment, in order to make you agree to the treatment, he exposes to you that you are suffering. So he removes your numbness. The moment your numbness is removed, what do you experience? Pain. And then what do you say? That the doctor caused the pain. No, the doctor has not caused the pain. The doctor has just exposed the pain. And if the pain has been exposed, now there is a chance that the pain will be relieved. Some treatment may happen. So when you experience that pain, kindly do not move away from the truth. Are you getting it? Continue to be with it. Have patience. If you say that you come to the sessions, if you say that if you listen to me, you feel uneasy, then continue to feel uneasy. You have that strength. You won't collapse. You'll soon wade through all this and then something else awaits you. A new way of living. A fresh mind. A life not wasted. And your situation is not only inevitable, but also fairly common. Nobody who has strayed away from peace has re-obtained peace except by passing through his peacelessness. You see, your house is in a jungle. It's a pretty cozy home that you have there in the middle of the jungle. But for some reason, you stray away. You have come afar. You are lost in the jungle. Now, even if you have to go back to your house, you will have to pass through the jungle. It's just that this time you are passing for your own welfare. This time it is a return journey. The jungle is the jungle of suffering. The home is peace. Truth calls only those who are away from truth. Otherwise, why would the truth call? Calls are needed. That's why you are called. And if the calls make you feel uneasy, you should understand that you must attend to the call with even more respect. Not block the number. You'll have to stay with it. You'll have to be patient. And that patience comes naturally when you are not afraid of suffering. When you say that I'll live through it, I'll pass through it. In fact, I am sure I can even enjoy it. Yes, this is what has also been conventionally referred to as sadhana or tapasya. That is nothing but returning home by passing through the jungle of suffering. Yes?